IP and data warehouses.
Okay.
Data warehouse is basically again a database only, relational database, but we don't go up to three normal forms. Normally we end with first normal form. So to work with MSBI, MSBI is basically a stack of applications. It has got about three different applications under its suit. So one is SSIS, SSAS and SSRS. SSIS basically means for integration services.
Okay.
So integration services meaning is, it is the MSBI means for business intelligence. It's mostly required for, say, decision makers, for decision support people. This kind of applications are needed very much. Whenever you work with data, we have two different types of databases. One is OLTP, other one is OLAP. OLTP stands for online, transaction processing, and OLAP is analytical processing. In the transaction processing, you are going to record the transactions. As they take place, you record them. Okay, but this OLTP databases, they are time variant. From time to time, they can change. And after some time, what happens? They may not have any significance. Okay, so in such cases, we move such information into warehouses. We keep data in the warehouse. Once data is available in the data warehouse, you can take decisions. So that becomes actually historical data. Based on the historical data, you can take decisions for the future. So this is required in decision supporting, decision making process. So most of the company CEOs, similarly CIOs, CEOs, those kind of people, they actually analyze the data. So for such purposes, we can use this MSBI. So in the MSBI, very first thing is integration services. The second thing is analysis services. Third one is reporting services. Imagine one scenario. See, there are many like retail outlets. One example is retail outlet. Something like more supermarket you find across country. And funny, you are from which place actually? Your time zone? Are you in India or outside India?
Outside India.
Okay, you stay in US?
Yes.
What's your time zone?
EST.
EST, okay. Fine. So, for example, you take like these retail outlets. Something like more supermarket you may take. Similarly, they may be like food world kind of things. They have a chain of outlets across the country. Mostly in big cities, they are located. But in some small towns also, they may be located. Okay, normally, these outlets, they are run by private people based on the franchise. Like that normally these are run. So what happens, you take retail outlets, one retail outlet is in Hyderabad, one may be in Tirupati, one may be in Karimnagar. So like this in different locations, you have outlets. But the outlets which are in Hyderabad may be doing very good business. They may be using sophisticated hardware and software. Okay, they may be using a network of computers. They may have actually some internal networking kind of thing. Multiple people also, they may be transacting, they may be making sales and all those. So in such cases, they use somewhat sophisticated equipment. Modern software also they use, with that they are going to capture the transactions. As they take place, they capture transactions. Similarly, go to Tirupati. Probably the Tirupati, they may not be this much sophisticated like Hyderabad, but still they are using somewhat better. As far as Hyderabad is concerned, we may use some softwares like SQL Server database. Then you may have some applications with that they do it. And when you go to Tirupati, probably they maintain using Excel. And if you go to places like Karimnagar, probably they may be putting everything on a paper. At the end of the day, they put into some notepad document, some Word document, then they send it. Where they send, at the end of the day, all this data should be accumulated at the, say, head office. Head office probably in Delhi or in Mumbai. If you take more megastore, you find head office in Mumbai. Most of the head office are in Mumbai only. So you need to send at the end of the day. What these people they do, they collect all this data from different sources. See, from Hyderabad is SQL Server data format. When it comes to, say, like Tirupati, it's in Excel format. And when you take like Karimnagar data, it's in the normal text format. So So these are called as the sources in different formats. We need to pull data from all these sources and we have to convert into a common format. Then we keep in the data warehouse. So data warehouse is nothing but collection of data from multiple sources. We pull data from multiple sources and keep in the data warehouse. So once data is prepared, you can start analyzing. Analysis probably you do every week or every month, say or every 6 months, depending on our requirement, we can be analyzing data. So what analysis we can make? What product is sold more? I mean in all these outlets, overall what product is sold more? What product is sold more in Hyderabad? Okay, what product is sold more in Tirupati? So like this you can be analyzing data, different types of analysis. Which customers are coming regularly to us? Okay, which category of products are being sold more and more? Okay, whenever there is some price fluctuation, how the product is behaving? That means people are buying it or not. So if it is compulsory, then in that case whether the price increases or decreases, it does not make difference, they can buy. So like that, they can come to many types of conclusions. So all this has to do with the SSAS. SSAS stands for SQL Server Analysis Services. The available data in the warehouse, we can actually analyze. So once that is analyzed, ultimately, you have to show some like, say in the dashboards you have to show. Or you may be showing in the graph, or you may be making as a report. So like this, in different forms you can show that you will do with the help of the SSRS. SSRS stands for SQL Server Reporting Services. So this is called as SQL Server Reporting Services. So like that, you can be maintaining, you can be using all these applications together. This is called as stack of applications. SSIS, SSAS and SSRS.
Yeah.
Yes, Pani?
You are saying that MSBI basically used to analysis and reporting once the data is there in the data warehouse.
Yes.
It's also useful, also you can use to enter the data warehouse.
See, you may not enter from different sources, you pull data and you put into the data warehouse.
So,
data may be available in different formats. Even if you take an organization, there can be number of departments. In one department, data can be in one form. But to improve overall organization, you require inputs from multiple sources. Take organizations like ONGC, for example, you take. In the case of ONGC, you have different departments. In one department, probably they use Windows OS. If you take another department, probably they use only Linux, Unix. So what happens in this case, data format is going to be changing. From multiple sources, data is brought together and kept in a warehouse. Once data is available in warehouse, you can process that. So the processing you do with the help of the OLAP, that is called online analytical processing. So that you can do with the analysis services, something like SSAS. It's not limited to only SSAS, overall I am saying, but these are the tools from Microsoft. Even something like Informatica you have, Cognos you have, with that you can do, or one more thing is Tabby software is available, with that you can do, Variety Business Intelligence you have, even with that you can do, or else if you are capable of doing yourself all the things, you can code it, you can do. But that is a daunting task. So when you have tools available, you can simply use them. I mean, the effort you are going to put is less. At cheaper price only, you can be getting all the tools, then you can make it working. So this MSBI is one such platform. Here you have SSIS, SSAS and SSRS. But prerequisite for doing this, I mean MSBI is, you have to be good with the SQL Server. First of all, you have to know about SQL Server. Because when you look at this SSIS, it not only needs for ETL operations, not only for ETL, even you can be sometimes, I mean, administering SQL Server using SSIS. You can administer SQL Server with the help of the SSIS. So prerequisite for this is, you have to know about some relational databases. And if you know the SQL Server, then that will be very, that will be very, very good for you. Easily, you can start using the SSIS, SSAS and SSRS. Yes, you're saying something funny?
Yes, I got it. Hey,
okay.
Can you give me some information about OLTP also with an example? I know I understand what you're saying for data warehouse.
Yes, see. OLTP, for example, see, you have an organization in that you have a department called as purchases. Okay. In the case of purchases, you may generate a purchase order. As soon as you generate purchase order, what happens with that? And then it is going to be in the pending state. Initially what happens, it's going to be in the pending state. You send it to supplier, supplier may be responding to that. So when supplier responds, probably says within two days, and then it can be, your requirements can be met like that, probably supplier may be saying, then in that case what you say, the flag you change it to in process. Once you get the required items, that means completed like this. So regarding the purchase order, what is happening, from time to time the data is getting changed. So this is called as basically time variant. From time to time what is happening, data can be changing. And mostly this OLTP we use for day to day operations. And this is called as here operational database. We can call this as operational database, whereas data warehouse is historical database. There is only past data or historical data. Data, I mean OLTP is present data. Right now on what you are working, that can be called as OLTP. Online transaction processing, current data can be called as OLTP. Current data, just you are going to record whatever transactions are taking place. So then after some time it becomes past data. This past data you can move into warehouse, then you can take decisions. So like this you can be having both OLTP as well as OLAP. OLTP databases are going to be smaller when compared with the OLAP databases. Data warehouse kind of thing if you take, they are going to be huge, very very huge. If OLTP is in say GBs, the OLAP may be in TBs or it may be in PBs, either in petabytes or in terabytes you have data. But whenever you talk about this OLTP, mostly it runs into gigabytes. In gigabytes and in GBs only, mostly you find. So these are day-to-day operations which you record, that can be called as OLTP. OLTP databases are very small. For recording day-to-day transactions, we use it. Whereas OLAP databases we use for analyzing data, mostly for analysis purpose. You can think it as read-only data. So past data we take, we analyze it. So with the help of the decisions you can take for the future, for that purpose we use it. So this OLTP data, after some time it becomes actually historical data. It is time variant. From time to time it can be changing. After some time what happens, it can become past data. So when it's becoming past data, probably you move from OLTP to warehouse. So from warehouse you can make the analytical cubes, you can analyze data. So normally OLTP databases they can be SQL Server, or you can use flat files also, ROLAP we say, ROLAP or MOLAP, like that we are going to be using. So like flat files only we are going to maintain. That is somewhat advanced technology. So with the optimizations that is written, so once data is available in the cubes, you can retrieve it very fast. Data retrieval can be made very fast, and mostly you have in that either detailed data or summarized data. You can get summarized data, you can get, you'll be having in that, say, detailed data, whatever you want to get, you can get. Normally, data warehouses have two different types of tables, dimension tables and fact tables. You have dimension table and other thing is fact tables. In the fact tables, you have only figures. In the dimension tables, you have subject. See, dimension table may be something like customer is a dimension, product can be a dimension, date can be a dimension. So similarly, say store can be a dimension, location can be a dimension. So like this, you can have different dimensions. So these can be called as subjects. Whereas if you take the fact tables, there you have the quantity. So one is what here, how much sales are made, how much quantity is sold. So like that you can be having information. So that is called as basically fact tables. There you have measures. With the help of fact table, you can be measuring all these subjects. If you take a customer, how many sales the customer has made, you can have that. So in the given period, in the month of January or in the month of February or March, like that, how many sales are made, you can have in the, say, you can have in the fact tables. Similarly, you take a particular product, how many cases the products are sold, you can have. If you take a date, on the given particular day, how many products are sold, like that you can have information. So if you take a location, so in that location, what the customers are coming, like the different data, you can actually analyze, you can derive different kind of information. So that way we use here data warehouses. Data warehouses are actually very big in compared with the OLTP databases. Either we use star schema or we can use snowflake schema with the help of that they can be built. So in a nutshell, what we can say, this BI is business intelligence. I mean, it's meant for actually decision support people, but decision makers is very much required. If you take even information systems, one is PPS, the other one is MIS, one more thing is we have DSS. TPS, transaction processing system, mostly clerical kind of people, they are going to be recording transactions. The outcome of that they never bother. As the events occur, they try to record it. That can be called as basically transaction processing system. MIS, I mean that is management information system, middle level managers, sometimes they need to take decisions, say for the time being, on daily basis or on weekly basis, they can take decisions. In such cases, MIS databases we can use. Whereas decision support people, they require something like the analysis of the data, what is past data, whatever is available, that can be taken, that can be analyzed, and based on the analysis, they can be taking better decisions. So for that purpose, we can use OLAP, whereas OLTP is needed for So OLTP is only for the operational, for day to day we use the OLTP databases, whereas data warehouses, they are meant for the historical data. Then with the help of these tools, you can be integrating data first of all with SSIS, and using analysis services, you can be analyzing, and with the help of reporting services, you can make the reports.
Hey, quick question.
Yes.
Today you are giving some high-level introduction about the data warehouse that may not be here, or it's part of like you are started actually.
Yes, funny.
Means you already started the introduction. You want to provide the demo today, or even you actually started the chapter one or chapter two course?
No, just I am discussing. Just I am trying to interact with you. It is not. I did not start anything. I am just trying to share a few points related to this one.
Got it. That is what I feel is you are explaining everything like stack tables, everything. So I thought a little bit fast. So go ahead. No, not a problem.
No, I mean it can be slow when we start developing. Overview I am giving. Overall idea. I am trying to leave exactly. And one more point what I am stressing is, you have to know SQL Server, I am saying that funny.
Okay.
Because if you know SQL Server, then in that case, it can be quite easy for you. Without knowing SQL Server also you can do, but sometimes when you have to leave the SQL Server, little bit stumbling you, in face, that's what I say. So,
okay.
You know SQL Server, that can be good, that's what I say. And you need to download these softwares also, to make this SQL Server MSBI running, you need to have these softwares. SQL Server 2014 file version you download. This is the latest software, 2014 file version. This is about 2.2.2 GB. This you can download and you can install. Up to 6 months you can evaluate it. So when you download this, you can start working with the say MSBI, because with the SQL Server there are three services they run. One is SQL Server, the second thing is SQL Server service we say, then we say integration services, this is again a service, that is service it runs, then you have there analysis services, service also we have, this also runs in the background. One more thing is reporting services. So reporting services, service also runs in the background. So without having SQL Server, these services cannot be running. They are part of the SQL Server. When you install SQL Server, automatically these are available. Integration services, analysis services, and reporting services. But with what version of SQL Server? Only with enterprise or professional, okay, or standard editions, without these are available. But when you take express editions, these are not available.
Okay.
You have different versions of SQL Server. You have Enterprise Edition, then you have Professional Edition, you have Standard Edition, then one more thing is you have actually Express Edition. Express Editions, of course, we can download, we can use. But here the condition is what you cannot have these services. All these are going to run as Windows services. They are going to run just in the background. Okay. So they are going to be running in the background using some client interface. You get connected to these services. These services, they are going to listen for the commands from the client applications. You may have SSMS. SSMS stands for SQL Server Management Studio. You can give commands against SQL Server database. So there you give command, you execute, the command is sent to SQL Server instance, and that is going to be executing the command for us. So SQL Server as a Windows service runs in the background. In fact, it works as a network service, because from a distant computer also you can be accessing it. If it is a local service, then you cannot access from the external computer. But to access from an external computer, it should be like a network service. Then in such cases, you can be executing SQL Server, just like Oracle. So integration services also like a service, they are in the background. Analysis service also they are in the background, and reporting service also that run in the background. Okay. So normally, SSMS, Pani?
You are saying that these services are running in background, right? Announcements and reporting services, and these are working. So which application you basically call these services? Let's assume you said data warehouse materials, you can take all different
client applications are required. To access SQL Server, we can use SSMS.
Okay.
For example, idea start SQL Server Management Studio, I say. This one is Management Studio. With the help of this, I can be accessing SQL Server database.
Okay.
Okay. Or else, if you are good with programming, if you know the intricacies of SQL Server, you can develop one such application with that also you can be accessing SQL Server.
Okay.
This is what exactly a client tool. It's called as a management tool, a client tool with which you can be accessing the SQL Server database.
Okay.
So this can be a SQL Server database, a SQL Server Management Studio. With this, I can be getting connected to the SQL Server database. It will not start now because the service is right now stopped. I need to start the service, then in such cases it can be running. For some time it tries to get connect, it's giving information C. So here the service is not running. Then what I do, I can go to the service, then I'll be launching the service here. I'll be starting the service in this. Now for this purpose, I go to all programs. From here, I can be choosing the configuration for the SQL Server. So here, I have configuration tools. Then I go to SQL Server 2014 configuration manager. Then here, I can change. I should be starting service. Then I can access SQL Server. If you look at this here, SQL Server, MS SQL Server is stopped here. You have this kind of information. Similarly, when you look at this, SQL Server analysis service also stopped here. SQL Server reporting service also stopped here. Even SQL Server agent also stopped. Agent is used for automating things. That means, periodically, you have to, send some email from SQL Server environment, or you may be uploading some file. For such things, you can use here agent. SQL Server agent you can do, you can be using them. So now when it comes to SQL Server, I can start the service now. Click on this, then what I say, start.
Hey, Sridhar.
Yes.
You're trying to connect a SQL Server which is installed on your PC against the server, or you're trying to connect to your server which is on the remote?
Yes. From a different computer, you'll be accessing this server. So in such cases, you use SQL Server authentication, with that you can be connecting.
Okay.
So in the local system, where you have the same system.
Not the server, right?
Yes. SQL Server, and as well as some applications, when you have in the same system, probably you can use their Windows authentication. In such cases, whatever username and password you use for logging into computer, same can be applied. But when you access from a remote computer, in such cases, definitely you need to give user ID and password.
Okay.
So now what happened here? It has opened databases. I can expand here, database. So whatever database are available, I can see from here. But databases, they are just getting shown here. It is not owned by SQL Server Management Studio. This is only client tool. Just like a client tool it is working, it is getting data from the SQL Server instance, then it's showing. So whenever you type some command, it goes back into server, in the server that will be getting executed. Getting my point, funny what I am saying?
Yes, sir. One quick question.
Yes.
We are trying to connect to the SQL Server database, right?
Yes.
So these are the database, the login, DB, all these are the databases, right?
I create all these databases here. Okay.
So I have two questions in my mind. So what is the difference between, is there any data warehouse available in these databases?
See, data warehouse we need to make. Here see, AdventureWorks DW 2014 you have here. This is nothing but data warehouse. Data warehouse we need to make. Data warehouse is also nothing but normal database only. But okay. Here we have dimension tables and fact tables.
Okay.
We need to make these tables also. These are like normal tables only. If you go to DIM account, what columns you have in this? You can have like this, account key, parent account key, this is called as primary key here, the rest are going to be normal keys. So, it is going to be just like normal database only, but here, the normal relation cannot be up to three normal forms. We end only with the first normal form normally. Only, we end up with the primary key, that much.
Okay.
Here what happens, there can be, data can be redundant. That means same data can be, getting duplicated, triplicated, multiplied across the tables, but we don't bother in that case because it is basically meant for performance. Whenever you normalize, joining data from more than one table can be really time consuming process. Okay, so in the analysis, we should not be wasting time, very quickly we have to take. So there is no problem even if it's not normalized, if same data is, available in more than one table, there cannot be any problem. So therefore, quantitatively, we don't normalize up to three normal forms. So we just end up with creating primary key with the warehouses. These concepts also you have to know what is actually normal, what are normal forms, what is first normal form, what is second normal form, what is third normal form, and when you create database, what are the constraints we use, like primary key, foreign key, check constraint, null constraint, total constraint. So what are these you have to know. So when you understand all those, then after that if you come to the MSBI, probably you enjoy subject very much. At the same time, you can be working with lots of confidence and with aggression.
Okay.
That's what is needed, funny.
Okay. So, sir, you're also helping me on the database concept, right?
Yes.
Okay.
But before that, you need to download this software. That's very, very important. SQL Server 2014 trial version 2.2 GB. It's going to be up to 2.2 GB. You need to download this SQL Server 2.2 version. Not 2.2, sorry. 2014 trial version. I'm saying about size here. This is going to be just size. Okay. Then one more thing. To work with MSBI, you need to have here SSDT, SSDT we call it underscore BI, this is 2013 you need to download. These two you have to download. Okay, and further to work with these, you need to know about SQL Server, then similarly you have to know about XML, okay, similarly you need to know about what are web services, similarly little idea you require what is HTTP, because similarly what is FTP, these all you have to know. These are required actually. So if you can know, this can be better, and little bit coding also if you know, sometimes it can be comfortable with SSIS. You have a script knowledge. Sometimes you need to write code. When existing tools, if they cannot solve your problem, most of the time, you never write any code. Everything is available, you just drag and drop and you connect one component to another component, they are going to be working. But sometimes, what happens in this case is, you have to write some code because existing tools, whatever tools you have, they may not be supporting your requirements. So in such cases, you have to write the script. Today morning, somebody who is working with the MSBI was facing same kind of problem. So we solved the problem using the script component. They were getting data from the I mean mainframe. So when data was coming from mainframe, the data normally whenever data flat file you take and you try to put into SQL Server kind of thing, first of all you need to find out the columns, what columns you have to use. Normally columns, they get separated with a delimiter, either space or comma or tab like that. But in the data what happens, the delimiter is not consistent. Distance, sometimes distance between two columns may be 3 or 4 spaces, next time only 1 space, so next time you have a tab space. So like that, what is happening, data is coming in a peculiar fashion. So in such cases, to convert it to a common format, probably you need to use scripting. We thought that way, we have solved problem. So like this, if you know scripting, sometimes it can be useful. So scripting you need to do either with the C# or with the DB.NET. If you know those, then definitely you can work with them comfortably. Okay. C#, either C# or DB.NET. Yes, Pani?
No, that's fine. Coming to the SQL Server, the services.
Yes.
You said SQL Server management, right? So this is the yes. only client, this is the only tool available to access this application, or is any other applications I can use to access these services?
No, no, SQL Server is required. Without installing SQL Server, these are not available.
Yes. So to access this integration services or analysis or reporting services, I need application, right? So you said
yes.
SMS is application where I can go and access this application, right?
So yes.
So other than SSMS, did I have any other client tool available to access this service?
Yes, yes, I think there are some tools are available, but for them you need to pay.
Okay.
You need to buy it. Otherwise you have to build on your own tool. That is not in task actually. Okay. Using SMO. It's actually SMO. SMO stands for SQL Server Management Objects. With the help of that, it can be built. But this is available for us. We just you can use, because in the industry they support only this. Suppose tomorrow, then in such cases they ask you this only. You have to know about the SQL Server, I mean SQL Server Management Studio, because they expect that you know this one. And it's only required for developers. End users does not use any of these. It's only for developers. End users, they can access data from some kind of application. That can be a Windows application or it can be web application. They can be accessing and they never write any commands. SQL Server commands they never write. Through the form, whatever forms you give to the web pages, through that only they are going to be, I mean, interacting. So here, whenever you develop applications at the time, you require the SQL Server Management Studio. Similarly, in this Visual Studio, you use for developing MSBI applications. So that is why developing only required. For end user, these are not required at all.
Yeah, can you give us some information, more information about developing an end user, like? Just give an example, please.
What is it, Pani? Can you repeat, please?
Yeah, can you give me some information about, I didn't get the, who is developing, what is the developing means and what is the end user means?
See, suppose you have to make some database. You are building some web portal. The web portal requires some kind of database. Okay. Who actually makes the database, the web application? Developers, they are going to make web application.
Yeah.
So for that, whenever data they are capturing, either users may be registering or they may be selecting products, if it is e-commerce site. So all that have to be stable in the database. So for that, we need to develop database or not first. That is done by the database developers.
Okay.
So database developers, first of all, they should be making database, then after that, that can be used in the application. So, being a developer, database developer, you are going to use these tools. With the help of that, you can develop the database applications. Database application means, first of all, you are going to create tables. Then after that, you create the mechanisms with which you can be accessing tables, like stored procedures or functions. You write. With the help of that, you can be accessing data. So all as a developer, you are going to do it. So once you develop, the database is tested thoroughly, then after that, database can be linked with the application. Application can be here, a web application, a website. So website is capturing data. That data, where they have to save, tomorrow they want to see the data. Where they have to save it? Somewhere in the database only they have to save. Then how can they save? because that's a different application, this is a different application. So in such cases, whatever database developers they develop, that can be linked with the say application. So with the help of that, data can be saved or data can be retrieved from the databases. So this development part is done by the developers. End user does not know anything about this. Okay, they just access the pages, whatever data they want to enter, it can be getting saved automatically in the database, and whenever they want to retrieve, it can be retrieved and shown. So end users are not going to, they don't know anything, they need not know all these things. It should be totally abstracted. So what is happening exactly? Developers, both database developers, application developers, they are developing all these. Then after that, they move this into the production. While it is in the production, end users they can access. End user means the users, normal users. They can be accessing, so they can manipulate many things. All that can be saved in the database or XML file, it can be flat file, it can be any kind of thing. So database is one such mechanism to save the data.
Okay, got it.
So this tool is required. I mean, when you have these tools, you can work SQL Server 2014, this prior version. At the same time, SSDB underscore BI 2013 is required. The interface is going to be something like this. I need to start here, this one also. I mean, here, analysis service is stopped, but I can take this one here. Okay, that is already started, integration service is running. So I can launch here and I show you some application how this SSIS is working. This one is here, Visual Studio 2013. I can be launching it. Like this, we can get the interface.
So you are saying I need a Visual Studio also?
Yes, yes. When you install this SSDBT BI, this Visual Studio comes.
Oh, okay, got it.
This tool I am saying, SSDBT BI. I can start a new project. Here in this case, what exactly I do? Okay. Here, I show you an example. So this is data flow task, we say it is called ETL. ETL stands for extraction, transformation and loading. Like this, I can take it here. With the help of this, this is somewhat complex. Now we don't have time to do anything complex. Project I say. This is here. SSIS simple example. I can look into some kind of sample sets here. Here it is containing like this, country name, salesperson, then like this, I want to calculate commission and I want to put into some other file, this one. So for that purpose, here what I do, I create sales commission. So here, what names we have based on that, we should make it. Okay. This is country name. Not this. These columns I require as it is, but here extra I want to make. Putting here. It is nothing but commission. I put like this. So this kind of file I want to make. Save as. Here this is going to be text file. Sales commission, I say this. .txt file. I can save on the desktop, this one. So here, first of all, I make a connection manager with which I can be getting connected to a flat file. This is going to be a flat file. We will click on add here. Here I need to add file sales input. I put here. You can click on this browse here. Then choose the file name. Sales it is. Sample sales is the data I have here. Next, after this, we have here columns. Columns are like country name, salesperson, sales and comma delimited disease. When you come to advanced, country name is string data, salesperson is string data, that is fine. But when you take sales, this cannot be string data, it should be numeric data for us. So I take it as DTI4. That is integer 4 I can take. Bring that OK. Then similarly, one more type of file I should make, that should be flat file output, that is. Again I go to flat file here, click on add, then this is here sales commission output. Output I write like this. Then here I can browse it and sales commission I can make. Just when I created some file, sales COMMN like this. I can click on open and columns, whatever columns are available, you can see from here. Country name, salesperson, sales and commission like this is available. When it comes to advanced, sales should be in this. This one is I4 data, that is. DT I4 we can take. This commission can be in the, floating point data also, it can be here. So we use this as here. DTR means real-time data I can use. So like this, I can be making data types. These are going to be connection managers, both of them are flat file. From flat file to flat file only, I can be making it. Now here, what I do, I can drag and drop data flow task. This is called one of the tasks, data flow task I made here. Then in this, what I do, I can drag and drop here. From here, I can drag and drop flat file source first of all. Choose this, then drag and drop here, flat file source. Then I click on this, then I need to configure first of all flat file sales input. Okay, this have taken. What columns are available to me? These columns are available. Country name, salesperson, then sales like this, these are available to me. Like this I made it. So from after this one, I should be creating one more column called as, this is derived column, I'll be making in this. One extra column I require. So I can create one more column from here. So I take input from this, output from this and take it input to this. So here in the derived column, I can create a new column called as commission. Like this I can make. So expression, some percentage of commission I have to put here. What I do here, I just drag and drop sales. Then I multiply with the 0.10 like this. 10% we can give as commission. So this is coming here as DT numeric. Like this, one extra column is added for us here. Now from here, what we require? We require one more source called as here, flat file destination. I can just drag and drop here. So from here, the output I can send to flat file. Then here I need to configure. This one, it is going to be here, sales commission output. When it comes to mappings, we can map now here. So things are getting mapped automatically. Country name is mapping to country name, salesperson is mapping to salesperson, sales is mapping to sales, and commission is getting mapped to commission. Like these columns are getting mapped. Click on OK. When you run this here, before you run, look in the file here. This file I close. Even other files also, sales commission, there is no data in this right now. Right now there is no data, but when I process that, I can be getting data into this one here. Let me process that, I can get data in that. what is the problem I get. You can see in this results what problem I get. Okay. So probably one of the columns is going to be some kind of error in that. Because of that, you could not get data. So we come into this. Let us open sales data, sample sales. One of the data is something like this year. ABCD we have here. So this data cannot be converted. So I delete data here. Then after that, once again I save this. I try to run this. Now in this case, you don't get any error. You can just execute. Now everything is working successfully. So in the source file you have 6 rows. They are sent to derived column. From derived column it has to flat file destination, ultimately getting saved. If you come to this year, it is going to be having data now. You have seen 34,000, 3,400, 4,500, 4,500, like this is giving you the commission also. So this way here it is working. This is nothing but here ETL operation, extraction, transformation and loading we have done in this. First of all, with flat file source we extract, and with the derived column we transform it, we add a new column, then after that what we do, we convert, we put into flat file. This is called as here loading. So SSIS is basically does ETL operation. Along with that, it can be performing some SQL Server administration tasks. Understood, Pani? This one?
I got it. Thank you.
So this way it can be done. But prerequisite is actually you need to know the SQL Server, and similarly XML also you have to understand. No. These two are very, very important. With a little bit C sharp or PB dot scripting.
Okay.
And these days actually in the industry they are looking for multi-faceted personalities. Like you need to know about something like .NET, you have to know about SQL Server, you have to know about MSBI. They are looking for all these kinds of things in fact. So situation something like that, but slowly you can build one by one. I mean the day one you cannot do all the things, but step by step after finishing one you can go to other, then other also you can in fact put into your skill set, all those one by one. Okay, fine. This is what exactly I want to show something. Any questions?
I'm good.
Okay.
So